sides of the box. But we have a little bit of a ridge here in the middle. We're going to have to get it planed flat so I can get it run through the surface planer, thickness planer, and get it sized a little better. Check. See what this square looks like. That looks pretty good. Thank you. Nice. These are the boards I'm going to be cutting the sides out of. They've been cut down and I've left them set overnight so they can settle and determine if they're going to warp any, so I can do my final round of thickness planing. This is a bird's eye maple. It's a really pretty wood. Look even better when it has a finish on it. Plan on cutting these into two sides on each one here, and then we'll pick the prettiest ones to make the final box out of. Just finished cutting my two tail pieces. Now I've got to cut the other two sides into a pin pattern, so I'll have a pins and tails type dovetail arrangement, just like this one here. We're going to do that now. Found the best way to do this is on a router table. Just gotta make sure everything is in the right spot before you begin. Flip it end over end. Do the other side. Felt something move on that, so we had to abort that and see what's going on. Here's the completed pin boards. There's two of them. Next thing we have to do is make some flat lateral cuts in this way. Adjustment to this board. I don't want to cut in to the bottom of this right here. That's real close. All right. over here and chisel these up just a little bit. What I've got to do is get in here and chisel off these little ears that are sticking out right there. Take your chisel and put it on there. Just kind of wiggle him in. Get that off. Now it's nice and square. Now we're test fitting everything together here. Sand it, finish it, and then glue it together, put a bottom on it. Now we're going to start constructing the base. I have planed up this wormy piece of walnut right here that will act as a base. It's going to have to be squared up and then cut off. We're going to do that now. Right, I now have that piece viced up. I'm going to look and see if the top edge is square. And it's pretty darn close. Maybe just a little off in the back there. And let's see how level it is. It's not too bad. Let's make a couple passes over here with the finishing plane. Shavings there. That looks pretty good. Next thing we're going to have to do is, this is the side we just surface planed. We got to make this side parallel to the other side. We can start to square it up. Nice worminess here. So we're just barely going to score this through here. Just enough to even it up. Make sure we're taking away from both sides. Maybe just a shade more. Maybe just a little bit more. Second off of there. Alright. Don't want to forget safety glasses and something to push it through. Placed our fence and now have our crosscut sled on the table saw here. We're now going to even up the end grains and make it truly square so we can pick the portion of what we want to use for the base. So let's get our blade height set correctly. Just want a wee little bit of that blade sticking up. Otherwise it gets dangerous. This fence, we're just going to flip it and cut the other side square. We're not cutting it to final length yet. We're just squaring the whole thing. So when we put a ruler or measuring tape on it or however we're going to do it, you'll have good even measurements. Got our box disassembled again. We're getting ready to go back over it with some fine sandpaper, just 800 grit. Smoother, but you can see that the fine dust get in there and clogs up the pores of the wood, so that'll have to be cleaned out. We're going to go back and hit it again with 1500 now. Everything has now been sanded on the outside. We just got done wiping it down with mineral spirits to get all the crap out of the grain. This base looks amazing. I've left it a little more rustic. It's not sanded down to the level that these sides are. Simply because I kind of liked it like that. So we're just going to leave it. Oh, it's probably about 320, 400 grit. Straight off the planer, basically. Okay, we've got it pre-assembled here again. Just to make sure everything fits before we start putting finish on it. But what I always like to do is sign the bottom of it. So I'll just put my initials on here and the date. We're now going to put this dado on the inside of each sidewall. Put this divider in there. We want that to float in there because this wood will contract and expand a little bit over time. We don't want it to push our box apart, so we got to leave a little room on all sides. Thank you. this can rest in there and float up and down. Let's see if we can get her assembled here. See if everything's going to fit. Floating in there, and it will act as a divider. Pretty neat. Okay, I have all my pieces laid out here. These are the inside surfaces. We're going to finish those first. I'm just going to be applying just a regular old water-based finish here. Big piece first, get my brush saturated. See, boy, that really makes that wood come alive. Across the grain here first. Make sure it's loaded up good, and then smooth it out going with the grain. And hopefully not wipe away my initialing on there too much. Always want to finish both the inside and outside of your work pieces. It locks out moisture on both sides. So if you leave one side unfinished, it can absorb moisture, and then over time your work piece will slowly curve towards the unprotected side. Set for about 15 minutes after we do this, and then we'll buff the excess off. Okay, it's been about 15 minutes. Now we're going to buff in what's left. Now I'm going to be putting finish on the front sides. Same finish as the other side, it's just a water-based finish. Put a little bit directly on the wood this time. A slightly thicker coat. Just using a foam brush for an applicator. Cross grain first. I'm going to smooth it out going with the grain. Taking a little more care on this side than I did on the back. Wow, that's pretty. This is going to be probably one of the finest boxes I've ever made. Boy, this base is going to be really nice. Got these outside bevels. Just have to get the center part and try not to let too much of the finish get stuck down in that corner right there, in that crevice. Boy, that wood comes to life. This is just straight up black walnut wood. Nothing real special about it other than just are cool patterns, and it's no special kind of walnut. Might as well get this. This is the divider. Safe to get on you. You just don't want to get fingerprinted onto the other side. Thank you. This is Aaron Parks that we're listening to. Really cool jazz pianist. Buff in this finish. It's been 15 minutes. See, some of it has started to soak in. Okay, we're going to try to get this glued together. Getting confused about what is what here. Son of a gun is fitting tight. I gotta step it up here a little bit. Come on, get in there. Here we go. We got very careful not to go smearing this glue on the outside faces of this box. Tap everything down square. Not do that right there. Now when this glue dries, we're just going to try to scrape it off best I can. Because if I try to get it off now, I just push it into the grain and then it becomes really difficult. Alright, the glue is pretty much dried. I'm now using a really sharp chisel. I'm gonna get in here and get this excess glue chipped off of here. We're gonna be real careful not to get into our finish. It's a little bit of tedious work, but it makes for a much nicer finished product. All the other sides. Now we're going to get ready and attach to the base here, but what we need to do is score this wood here just a little bit to give it a little better surface area to attach. So we're going to use what's called a woodpecker. Just put some divots in the bottom here, but being careful not to run this over your hand. Because that's a really bad day right there. Okay, we're now gonna get it glued down to its base. Being careful not to get glue in that joint right there in the middle. This will be the weakest point on this box because it's end grain to long grain glue joint, which is not real strong. It's because because of the way the wood fibers are. But we can't use too much glue or it'll squeeze out everywhere around the base and be really hard to clean up. Alright, let's get it placed on there. Okay, now we just need to add some weight. I think I'm just going to use my chisel box here. Make sure it doesn't move. And that'll do it. And there it is, finished product. Probably got 10 to 12 hours total in making this. We have put some felt pads on the bottom so it doesn't scratch hard surfaces. Pretty nifty. Ready for a pencil.